"Ho, ho, ho!" he cried in a joyous bass voice. "Here are both my tin men come to visit me, and they and their friends are welcome indeed. I'm very proud of you two characters, I assure you, for you are so perfect that you are proof that I'm a good workman. Sit down, all of you, if you can find anything to sit on, and tell me why you are here." So they found seats and told him all of their adventures that they thought he would like to know. Kuklip was glad to learn that Nick Chopper, the Tin Woodman, was now Emperor of the Winkies and a friend of Ozma of Oz, and the tinsmith was also interested in the Scarecrow and Polychrome. He turned the straw man around, examining him curiously, and patted him on all sides, and then said, "You are certainly wonderful, but I think you would be more durable and steady on your legs if you were made of tin. Would you like me to—"
"No, indeed," interrupted the Scarecrow hastily. "I like myself better as I am."
But to Polychrome, the tinsmith said, "Nothing could improve you, my dear, for you are the most beautiful maiden I have ever seen. It is pure happiness just to look at you."
"That is praise indeed from so skillful a workman," returned the Rainbow's daughter, laughing and dancing in and out the room.
"Then it must be this boy you wish me to help," said Kuklip, looking at Woot.
"No," said Woot, "we are not here to seek your skill, but merely come to you for information."
Then between them they related their search for Nimmy Amy, whom the Tin Woodman explained he had resolved to marry, yet who had promised to become the bride of the Tin Soldier before he unfortunately became rusted.